Now we can write down a general method for solving problems where we have to relate the force in the moments with the motion and as your body is moving in a plane. Okay, so step one is, of course, choose and show a coordinate system. Step two is to perform as much kinematic analysis as you can. And the goal is to find the acceleration of center of mass and the angular acceleration of the rigid body. Okay, so if you have one rigid body, you know, you're trying to determine both of these quantities as much as possible. If you have a system of rigid bodies, multiple rigid bodies, then you want to find out Ag and alpha for every one of them. Okay, and that typically happens when you have a linkage system which may have three moving rigid bodies. Okay, if you can't find Ag and alpha completely, you may be able to find something about their direction, something about their magnitude, or even maybe a relationship between the center of mass acceleration and angular acceleration. Okay, so remember, Ag in a plane is given as Ag in x direction I hat plus Ag in y direction j hat. So you can find just this component, maybe just this component, or both the components, or maybe you don't know what AGX and AGY are, but you know the direction they're pointing in, okay? Same thing with the alpha. Alpha in a plane, for a rigid body moving in a plane, would be perpendicular in the plane. So you want to find the alpha. If you don't know alpha, maybe you can find A somehow as a function of alpha, all right? In that case also, your problem will become, you know, far more simpler. So please don't neglect any information given to you in the problem. Use as much as you can. But the goal is to get center of mass acceleration as well as angular acceleration. Step three is to draw free body diagram of rigid bodies. Okay, so I'm going to write S in the parenthesis to indicate that if you're more than one, you have to draw free body of all of them. So you can kind of see that we are basically writing everything that looks familiar to you, right, from module 3 on general method for kinetics of particles instead of rigid bodies. So far everything has been same, except that there was no angular acceleration for the particles, and of course we didn't have to write A sub g because all the mass was concentrated at one point, which could be seen as center of mass as well. Step 4 is to use Newton Euler equations, which are sigma f equal to m times kg and sigma mg equal to ig alpha. And another form of this equation is, if you take moment about another point, let's say q, then this is equal to position vector of center of mass with respect to q cross m times acceleration of center of mass plus ig alpha. Okay, so you can use either of those two equations. So now you will notice that if you know Ag and alpha from the step number 2, you can substitute them in here on the right hand side, and then hopefully you will have, you know, just the enough number of unknowns and the enough number of equations to solve for them, right? So how many equations you will have, how many scalar equations? This will give you two scalar equations in a plane. This will give you only one equation, which will be along, you know, k hat direction perpendicular to the plane. So you'll have three equations altogether from here, and you will be able to solve for three unknowns. If you don't know Ag and alpha completely, then you will have to count the equations that you get in the step 2 and then solve for them, right? So that leads to the final step, which is to solve for unknowns.